Self-centeredness. It's not an exciting subject because it has to deal with me. You know, here's the foundation scripture that I want you to get over in James chapter 4. So powerful, man. I'm telling you, when you get a hold of this truth, this transformed mine and Jennifer's life. I'm serious. We were very self-centered people. It was all about us. We did not, we were about us. We were about our family. We were about our kids. And that was it. And all the pain and all the hurt that we experienced was because it was what people did to us, what people said about us, what people, you know, that kind of thing. The pain that you're experiencing, the hurt that you've had because of what other people did, it's because you have a problem with self-centeredness. Yeah, I'm being really bold and really strong about this, but it's not about what they did. Because if you are healed in your heart, if you know, I'm going to get to the scripture in a second, but if you know who God has created you to be, then what other people do and what other people say isn't going to affect your heart. The scripture's in James chapter 4. It says that God resists the proud. It actually says he resists the proud, but gives more grace to the humble. Now, next week, I'm going to start talking to you about what that means. What does it mean to be humble, to experience God's grace? Let's talk about it next week. That's Life in 90.